Dear friends, I am Parvinder from West Highlander and I welcome you all in this video about New Zealand study visa. Two important points of funds requirement if you would like to apply for your student visa in 2023. In this video, I would be speaking about two very important points the students must take care of. The first one is acceptable funds as per Immigration New Zealand, and the second one is acceptable sponsors as per Immigration New Zealand. So friends, keep watching for complete information. One of the very important factors on which the success of your study in New Zealand visa application depends is the funds. As per the policy, the students must have enough funds to support themselves for their tuition fee as well as cost of living for the entire duration of the course. Now, there are certain funds which are acceptable and there are certain funds which may not be acceptable. The funds which are acceptable by Immigration New Zealand are savings held into your bank account, any FDRs, that is fixed deposits, education loan. These are few examples of the funds which are accepted as a part of the New Zealand visa application process. Along with funds being held in this form, there are certain other conditions the applicants must fulfill, like these funds must be held over a period of time. If these funds are recent and you do not have an acceptable and a verifiable source for these recent funds, then these may not be acceptable as a part of the visa application process. If you have got education loan, then the education loan sanction letter must mention the conditions as per Immigration New Zealand. Like there are certain conditions which must be there on the education loan, like the security against which the loan has been sanctioned. This security must be in the name of an acceptable sponsor. What is the rate of interest? In how much time would you repay this loan? What is the repayment plan? These are few of the things which the students must mention in their visa application process. If you have got funds which are new and are sourced from, let's say, gold loans, Kisan credit cards, then these funds may not be acceptable as the part of your visa application process. So the students must take care that they submit the funds which fulfill the policy of student visa. The second point which the applicants must take care is that the funds must be held in the name of acceptable sponsors. There is a list of acceptable sponsors, that is the people who can support you for your study in New Zealand. This list includes your parents, your grandparents, both set of grandparents, that is paternal grandparents and maternal grandparents, your real brothers, sisters, your spouse and your parents-in-law. If there are any other person other than these as I spoke, then they may not be acceptable as your sponsor for your New Zealand study visa. So the applicants must take care that they submit the funds in the name of acceptable sponsors. Friends, I hope you find this information useful. For any query you may have about your study in New Zealand, please contact West Highlander. We are a team of experienced and expert counselors who can help you throughout the process. Thank you.